guys, and welcome back to my channel, Evangeline's Art Spot. Sorry I've been a bit MIA lately. A lot of stuff was happening, and it seemed like it was all happening all at once. So the past couple of months have been really hard for me, but I'm back, hopefully. I'm gonna try and upload a video every so often. I'm not gonna have any scheduling or anything. I'm just gonna get it up when I can. I notice that when I have a certain schedule, I tend to rush drawings, and I want you guys to be able to enjoy the arts that I present to you guys, so I hope you enjoy this video. Today I decided to draw you guys a depiction of a Chinese, like, teenager's room. I always loved how the decor works for the Chinese rooms. I like had three separate pictures for it. So this picture has multiple references of many other Chinese rooms that I used. So I mixed them all together into this one room, and I think it turned out good. The one thing that I could complain about is the girl. Like, something seems off about her. I'm not really used to having people like lay down or sit or anything like that, so I'm really working on that. So I just noticed when I start drawing the girl later on in the video that she's kind of like squished, but I didn't know how else to fix it, so I just left her alone, and I decided to embrace the mistake that I had made. How are you guys doing with the last couple of months passing by? Are you guys ready for 2019 yet? I'm definitely not. 2018 has kind of been like rough, but it's been slow at the same time. The last couple of months have gone by fast because, you know, I was going through a lot of stuff, but I feel like 2019 really was kind of slow for me. Let me know how your guys' 2019 is going so far. Because I was gone for so long, I decided to let you guys see what I've been working on for the last couple of months. This one's of my friend's dog, Timber, that had passed away. I drew this one because I am obsessed with plants right now, and I just love them and how it brings an apartment to life. I drew this one on the 31st of October. It was supposed to be an Inktober drawing, but I didn't find any of my ink pens, so I just did it on the iPad. It was Slice. And then this is the last one that I drew. It was the Dale Little Smithos girl, and I actually really enjoyed drawing her. It was really fun, and that was one of my most favorite drawings I've ever drawn on the iPad as of recently. Because I had so much fun drawing the girl with a bunch of plants, I wanted to draw like my perfect decor. Like, I wish my apartment looked like this. I wish it was so elegant and unique to, you know, everyone around me. But, you know, apartments, you can't really put wood paneling on the wall. So I have what I have, but this is basically my dream room. Thank you. So the reason why I've been gone for so long was because I recently found out there's been some medical problems with me, and I'm supposed to be getting surgery sometime this month. And it's actually quite scary because I've never had a surgery before. Comment down below if you actually had a surgery. It might calm my mind just a little bit. But because of this recent thing that I found out was wrong with me, I haven't really been drawing. When I tend to get stressed out, sometimes I just let the stress take over my mind, and I don't really think about it. Like, I don't think about drawing as relaxing. I see it as more as like something that's taxing to me, because I'm just trying to focus all of my time and all of my energy into what's stressing me out. And then I end up getting sick, and then I just stress myself out to the point where I'm just barely here. I'm just focused on what's happening, because I feel like if I don't focus on the thing that's stressing me out, then it's not gonna fix itself. I feel like if I stress out, I have somewhat control over what I'm stressing out. And yeah, so that's why I haven't been uploading any videos or really drawing any. Some of those drawings were like 2 weeks, and then I take a month hiatus, and then I do one for another 2 weeks, and then another month. So I'm actually really happy to be back and drawing now. I need to stop letting stress take over my life and just realize that drawing is my outlet. Drawing relaxes me, and sometimes it's hard to remember that when I am stressed out. So let me know in the comments down below if you have the same problem. The thing I love most about the iPad recently is being able to zoom in and get those meticulous little details that you normally wouldn't be able to do in traditional drawing unless you were like super good, in which I am not. I tend to get too impatient, especially if it's with paper and pencil and erasers. I feel like if I draw too much on the paper, it's just gonna like do that thing where the paper kind of goes away as you erase, and that really bothers me, and I hate just restarting the whole picture. So it's been really nice being able to erase as much as I want without the paper coming up and having eraser marks everywhere. So I really actually love digital drawing a lot more than traditional drawing. Like, I still go back to it every now and again if my iPad is dead, but I still really love digital drawing more than traditional. I apologize for not being so talkative in this video. I just want you guys to be able to sit down and relax and just watch me draw, because sometimes that's just what you need. You don't want any of the commentary, you just want the music and just to watch the person do what they're doing. So I'm letting you guys get a little bit of that today. Thank you. So the quote that I had written in kanji over here is actually from Helen Keller. And the quote is, "The best and most beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt with the heart." I thought that would be so good for this drawing since I'm getting back into YouTube and getting back into drawing more frequently because of all the stress that's been going on. I just feel like this quote really touched me, and so I decided to put it in this picture. I've been really getting into using black for shading instead of, you know, some of the same colors for shading. I really like how it gives the picture depth, and sometimes I'll use the same color if I kind of just want to give it that little shaded look, but most of the time I will start using black for the shading, as you'll see at the very end. I just feel like it gives it a lot more depth and a lot more, what's the word I'm looking for? Realism than if I were to just use the colors. And I love how the contrast is if I use black instead of just darker colors than what I'm using. In about 0.5 seconds, you're about to see me go from this angle to the angle of upside down. I didn't realize that my iPad was upside down while I was drawing my kimono for this girl. And it just, it's upside down now, and I didn't want to go back and redo the whole thing. So I just left it upside down. Hopefully you guys can see it okay. Problem with her hand that's on the book. It's still in a kind of a weird position, but I couldn't think of any other pose that it could have been with her in this pose. I just think this pose is just so weird. The reference I was looking at, it was kind of weird. I feel like it was Photoshop maybe to make her look like she was like this. I have no idea, but I did the best that I could because I wanted her to be laying down, you know, relaxing in her bed, reading a book, but it didn't really turn out. turn out to be like that, really. It turned out to be something else. So, yeah.
Thank you.
guys for stopping by and watching my video. If you like it, please hit the like button and subscribe. And at the very end, I'll post my Instagram so that way you can go follow me there too, because I post on there all the time about my art, never about personal stuff, just art. So, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye now.